Oh, greetings, 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 Chapelton Primary School. Greetings to students and the parents and the teachers. Today is Parent Day, and your theme, I have been told, is Fathers Rise, Lead, and Be Wise. I love your theme. My name is Dr. Debra Williams, aka Dr. Debs. For those of you who may have seen my videos on YouTube or on Facebook, I have a company called Life Health and Foods Wellness Center, and from there I teach persons across the world how to be in good health and prosper even as their soul shall prosper. So I am a 8-year cancer survivor, choosing not to remove the breast, choosing not to poison my body with chemo and radiation or hormone therapy, choosing instead to go back to the Lord, go back to the Garden of Eden. And the Lord has taught me how to be in good health and to teach his children how to also be in good health for his honor and for his glory. So I am what they call a naturopathic physician. I teach nutrition, I teach disease prevention, and I teach you how to recover from diseases using natural remedies if you have been afflicted by diseases. So when I heard about the theme, Fathers Rise, Lead and Be Wise, immediately Father Abraham came to my mind. Fathers, I encourage you today as men of God to lead your family after God. Listen to what God said about Abraham in Genesis 18 and verse 19. For I know him that he will command his children and his household after him, and they shall keep the way of the Lord to do justice and judgment, that the Lord may bring upon Abraham that which he has spoken of him. God is still looking for men that he can say, I know him, that he will command his children and his household after him, that they will do justice and judgment, that they will lead their children and their families after God. Now, gentlemen, fathers, welcome to my kitchen. Welcome to my world. Today, I want to talk a little about nutrition. In Jamaica, there are too many of our men coming down with prostate cancer. There's just too many of our women coming down with breast cancer or ovarian cancer. There's too much obesity among our children. Fathers, you need to rise. You need to lead. You need wisdom. Wisdom comes from having a fear of God, and the Holy Spirit will lead and guide and instruct. So how did I recover from cancer in 2012 without doing the conventional treatments? I went back to God and I went into the Bible, and God led me to a book called Ministry of Healing by Helen G. White. Let me grab that book and show you for a moment, right? So this is my book, Ministry of Healing by Helen G. White. I read the book and the book was very clear. The program is called New Start, Nutrition, Whole Food, Plant-Based Diet. Exercise, water, sunlight, temperance, air, rest, trusting God. These are the 8 laws of health. Having an attitude of gratitude, a spirit of benevolence, and cleanliness. So today, I want to show you what a typical whole food plant-based diet for optimum health looks like. When you eat like this and live like this, no cancer, no diabetes, no hypertension, no obesity, no arthritis, no high cholesterol, no aches and pains all over the body, right? No poor circulation. Now, we advocate fruits. In my kitchen today, I have my pineapple, I have my avocado. Anything with a seed in it is a fruit. Genesis 1:29, Genesis 1:11, God told us what is a fruit. So I have my papayas, I have my lemons, I have my grapefruit, I have my junco, right? So I always ensure that I have fruits in the house. Now, then I have my vegetables. So I always have callaloo and cabbage and carrot and beetroot. You want to ensure that you're eating like the rainbow. Some greens and some yellows and some orange. Our pumpkin is here. Then we want to switch away from the flesh. Too much flesh is building up uric acid. Too much cholesterol coming from the animal into the body. That's what is causing so much heart disease and stroke and cancer. The meat is being sprayed and is being pumped with too much steroids, antibiotics, too much hormonal injections going into these animals. So I want to go to a whole food plant-based diet. People will say, but Dr. Williams, the vegetable is sprayed. True, many farmers are spraying, but once you wash it properly and start your own backyard garden, gentlemen, build up a little area so your wives and children can start planting their kalo and their cabbage and their pak choy, right? We are becoming too dependent on going on the road, eating from people, and we don't know what they're putting on the vegetables. We're going to put away the flesh. What do we replace it with? Well, for protein, we need the amino acids building block. We get that from our peas and our beans, our nuts, and our seeds. So we have pinto bean, and we have black-eyed peas, and we have chickpeas, and we have red lentils, we have gungo, we have red peas. We have a wide variety of peas that we can make our bean stews, and we can make loaves with them, right? We can make veggie balls with them. It's endless. If you want recipes, you can go to my website, www.debrawilliamsja.com. And you will see recipes there, how to take these peas and beans and convert them to the most delicious stews and soups and veggie balls and veggie burgers, right? And then we have our brown rice. So we don't eat white rice and white flour. There's no nutrient. They have been stripped of their nutrients. We want to go with our brown rice, right? Our organic oats, our organic cornmeal, our sped flour. We want to go with our whole grain pasta, right? Our bulgur. Now we have our yam and dasheen and green plantain and green banana and our chocho string bean. There is no shortage in the Garden of Eden. There's no shortage in a whole food plant-based diet for us to get our carbohydrates, our proteins, our fats, our vitamins and our minerals, our phytochemicals, our antioxidants to stay in good health and prosper, even as our soul shall prosper. We have a busy morning and we're rushing off. The children have to go to school. Well, we give them some fruits, right? We give them some oats porridge or some cornmeal porridge or some banana porridge. But we don't use condensed milk. We don't use dairy. Instead, you get some coconut milk and put in the porridge. You get some sunflower seeds and make sunflower seed milk. You can use sesame seed and make some sesame seed milk, right? We have pumpkin seed, make some pumpkin seed milk. And then we ensure that we're feeding our children so they're not going on to school and eating junk food, eating snacks and up a sugar. We put away the sugar, we use a little honey instead, or a little molasses. So our children are getting the minerals that they need so their brain can function and they can learn, right? And have energy to feed their muscles so that they can go through and be healthy children for the honor and the glory of God. Now it's very important that we drink our water throughout the day. Very important. So put away the sugary drinks. Start consuming your natural water. From our neck down, we're 75% water. From our neck up, we're 85%. The brain sits in water. So we need to be drinking water throughout the day. Now, the program that I teach, the program I live by, the acronym is called New Start. Nutrition, a whole food plant-based diet. Exercise, water, sunlight, temperance, air, rest, and trust in God. These are the 8 laws of health. So fathers, as you rise, lead and be wise. Take your family back into the Garden of Eden. Take your family back to a whole food plant-based diet. Take your family back to exercising and drinking up the water. Take your family back to Bible studies in the mornings. Pray with your family before they go and watch God take your family and truly build successful families for the honor and the glory of God. Now I want to pray for the fathers today. Father in heaven, we thank you for your grace and your mercy. We thank you so much for Jesus Christ, your Son. We thank you, Father, for your Holy Spirit. We thank you for your grace and your mercy. Today, Heavenly Father, I want to pray a special prayer for our fathers. I pray, Lord God, that you'll fill them with your Holy Spirit. And indeed, that they will turn like Abraham and follow you and lead their children after God, so that your name can be glorified, magnified, and exalted, and that our men will gain good success because God is the one who will prosper them. We thank you, Heavenly Father, for our men. Bless the children, bless the families, and I pray, Lord, over this school that you will bless all the teachers and all the persons in the community. Is our prayer with thanksgiving. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. There you go, guys, from Dr. Debra Williams. I pray that you have learned something today to keep your families in good health for the honor and the glory of God. Have a wonderful Parents' Day.